Good afternoon students, welcome to class 10 biology class and your WBC and RBC completed. Next cell, this is the platelets or it is called the thrombocytes. What is this and what is the function of this cell? Okay, these are the colorless and oval round cytoplasmic fragment from the giant cell of bone marrow. Actually, all are the same in WBC, RBC and the platelet actually come from bone marrow. Bone marrow, you know, this is the in the bone, the soft tissue is present, is called bone marrow. From this bone marrow, here the one type of cell is present. This cell is called, this is the giant cells. Giant cell. What is this? This giant cells. Giant cells actually, this is called also megakaryotic. Megakaryotic means large lobate nucleus is present, and from this giant cells actually fusion of epithelial cell to the nucleus present to the outer membrane. From this cell, platelets are formed. Okay, or it is called thrombocytes. It is oval or round in cell. This is the platelet, another cell. And they are found floating in the blood. These are enucleated, without nucleus is present after maturation, bounded by membrane and few cell organelles also present. Their lifespan 55 to 10 days. What is the lifespan? Lifespan is the 5 to 10 days. This is the lifespan. And they release the chemicals and thromboblastin. Actually, the thromboblast or the thrombocytes, these thrombocytes or the platelet helps the blood clotting. Blood clotting means the blood count. This clotting helps in the, what is the main function of this platelet? Helps in the blood clotting. And different types of protein secreted, this is the thromboblastins, and with the process in actually the blood clotting. Blood clotting process later I will discuss in details what is the blood clotting, how the clot the blood. Okay, this is the blood clotting. But in blood vessel, blood are not clotted. Why? This is the heparin. Heparin is present, that's why blood is not clotted. But after any injury is formed on the skin, then blood, how they say blood clot, then helps the platelets, or it is called thrombocytes. Okay, this is the thrombocytes and the blood disease. Different types of blood disease is there. What is this? An increasing number of WBC much more than normal is called polycythemia. Polycythemia is the increase the number of RBC at the normal condition. From the normal condition, increase the number of RBC much more than normal is called polycythemia. Polycythemia. Okay, this is the increase. The RBC and it decrease RBC count is called erythrocytopenia. This is the increase RBC. This one is increase RBC and erythrocytopenia. This decreased RBC, erythrocytopenia, decreased RBC. These are the all disease I am talking about. And the enormous increase the WBC at the cost of RBC is called leukemia. Leukemia actually the blood cancer. When the increased number of WBC, then it is called the leukemia. Or this is the blood cancer. Actually the blood cancer, leukemia. Increased WBC and decreased WBC, leukopenia. Okay, this one is the increase, this is the blood cancer, and leukopenia, increased WBC. All are the increased blood disease. That is that this term have to remember, leukemia very much important. This is a blood cancer is a leukemia. When they increase, number of increase, the number of WBC, the cost of RBC, the number, this is called the leukemia. Okay. Next, what is the function of blood? Very important function of the blood. One by one, to remember all the point function of blood. All point have to remember. What is this? First one, point wise I am discussing. All points is very much important points. First point, transport of nutrients. Transport of nutrients means you know the digestion. After digestion, the food is completely break down and to form and converted into simple molecules. Carbohydrate converted into glucose, protein converted into amino acid, and the fatty acid and glycerol. After this is absorbed by the blood, then transported in different parts of the body through the blood. This is helps actually transport of nutrients. One of the most important function is transport of nutrients. This is the most important function in the include in blood. Transport of respiratory gases. In the RBC, RBC contain the hemoglobin. I have already discussed the RBC contain hemoglobin, and hemoglobin molecules can bind the four molecules of oxygen molecule, and also can bind the carbon dioxide. When the oxygen bind, then it is called oxyhemoglobin. When the carbon dioxide, the carboxyhemoglobin. It helps actually the transport of gases from the alveoli. It takes the oxygen and is entered. Transported different parts of body. From this part, different parts, carbon dioxide enters, then enter to the alveoli. Then the carbon dioxide exhales out from our body. Transport of waste. After metabolic waste, the carbon dioxide also metabolic waste, different types of metabolic waste is actually transported and this enter into the excretory system. This helps actually by the help of blood. Only the transport system is actually blood. Blood, not only blood, lymph and the tissue fluid is there, but most important thing is the blood. Transport of body secrets, different types of hormones. Hormones actually, what is this? Hormone is a chemicals. Hormone is a chemical things and it is secreted from endocrine gland. Actually two types of glands in our body, endocrine gland and exocrine gland. Endocrine gland, from this endocrine gland, hormone secret from this endocrine gland. This hormone is directly entered to blood. This is the actually that helps the transport of hormone and different types of secretions. Regulation of body temperature. The blood helps to control our body temperatures. Also the vasoconstriction, vasodilation process. The defense against infection. That contains the one of the most important cells. This is WBC. In the WBC lymphocyte, different types of cells is there which will help to produce the antibody. This antibody are produced against the antibody produced against the antigen to kill the antigens. Okay, it helps in our against infection. Maintenance of pH. pH they act as the blood actually act as the buffer and the plasma protein is there. They help the as a buffer maintain the pH of blood. And water balance. Water blood maintains the water balance to the constant level by bringing on the constant actually maintain our water balance in our body. And clotting of blood. Last one is the clotting of blood. Clotting of blood, this clotting, the blood clotting process, next video I will discuss. But what is this? Say blood in the platelet is present in the blood. This platelet helps actually that helps to blood clotting. Not only platelet, different types of factors is there helps, but most important is the thrombocytes. They also helps in the blood clotting, thromboplastin release. This helps in the clotting of blood, but not in the blood vessels. When any injury, any cut in our skin tissue, after that is helps in the clotting. Okay. I hope it's clear. Very much important function. Properly study, properly learn at your home.